Who is this?
What's going on, Chef? Rob, what's happening? This is Brother Malua. How you, brother?
All right, how you? Who is this again?
This is Brother Malua.
Oh, what's happening, man? How you feeling, man?
Man, I'm good, brother. Just out here working for our people, man. Trying to bring our race to the greatness and doing my part, man. You know,
man, you're doing a call, man. I got to give you a whole bunch of praise. I'm going to go ahead and play this a whole. I feel honored you called, brother. Really, really honored. And I recognize when I came to the meetings, man, I recognize, you know, that, hey, look, there, this is something that, hey, like, I need to push this message as much as fucking possible. I love what I saw, okay?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Well, you know, Marcus Garvey had the answer 100 years ago, and you just played one of the great students of the Honorable Marcus Garvey, Dr. Clark. You know,
yes, sir.
I mean, you know, when we're looking at the 21st century, as a matter of fact, the UNIA just celebrated the 104th anniversary of the beginning of the Universal Negro Improvement Association. And when it comes down to it, brother, you know, we've been whooped so bad, you know, that the Clark was talking about, you know, we are the greatest warriors, you know, but we've been conquered, man. Our people was conquered. We was whooped. We was beat down because we forgot to stay united on our only strength. And our strength is our unity, you know.
Wait a minute. All of us ain't beat down, now, goddamn it. I mean, I took a few licks, but I'm back up now. Come on.
No, we ain't gonna
fuck
stay
that.
Down, brother. But we got
I'm gonna take a few licks, but I ain't out. I'm back up. Hey. So, and I'm healthy.
Hey,
I'm ready.
Yeah. I'm up too, brother, and I'm swinging, and I ain't finna get whooped no more, you know. But the thing
is that, when we look at it,
you know, the black man, woman, and child all over the world, right? All over the world, we on the bottom. And ain't no way we should be on the bottom, man. When we was here first, we gave and we discovered and we made everything that's worthwhile for human life, you know, and all throughout the world, man, we've been loving everybody else except for ourselves. You know, black people, man, got to come together on the only thing we got in common, and that's our DNA. You know, I talk to black people all the time, and they are more protectionist for other people than they are for their own, you know, and we got to quit doing that. I'm talking about the mental shit that we went through.
I think that's like today it's like a mental disease when I see that shit, when I hear that. You know, at one time it was like, you know, they were controlled to be like that, but right now it's ingrained. It's almost a fucking mental disease. You agree?
Well, I call it a training, brother. I call it, you know, my thing is, man, just putting in everyday language. You know, growing up on the south side of Chicago, you know, a lot of the brothers that I knew, they had this dog called a pit bull. You ever seen a big, pretty pit? A pit bull, a pit bull, right, when everybody else see that pit, they know what that pit can do. They know that that pit, if it set its jaws on you, it ain't going to let go. That pit, man, you know, the way in which they come from, a pit will fight bad, you know. But the thing about it is a pit can go through the training that it can have the worst no good master. I'm talking about a master that don't feed him right, that beat him, that put chains around his neck to put him in a cage. It can have the worst no good master. But that pit will fight another pit to the death to protect that master. And what I see with our people is that we have become trained. We've become trained to be protectors of everybody else because we don't know our own majesty. We don't know, man. You know, we run around here, man, and we go at each other because it's safe to go at each other. But it's not safe for us to attack the one who's against us. You know, and the thing about it is that, you know, we got to combat that training. We have to be retrained. We have to be educated, man. We have to be taught, man. But, you know, we have to stand up, man, together, bro. All black people together. Race first, man. Marcus Garvey gave us a slogan that we have to use and we have to incorporate. Race first. All black.
But check this out. What should be the message to go ahead and so individuals understand that it's race first? How do you go ahead and get that out there?
Well, I mean, you got to actually, man, you got to target, you know, what people can understand, because there's levels to this shit, Brother Rob. There's levels to it. So what you have to do, man, is that you have to go ahead and you have to actually get to the most fundamental level of all human beings, and that's self-preservation. All right? So when it comes down to self-preservation, man, you got to teach a man that, man, do you want something that's good for you? And what's the offspring of you? The offspring of you or is your family. And what's the offspring of your family? The offspring of your family is your race. See, the thing about it is everybody else take care of theirs first. Everybody else take care of theirs first. But we're the only people that feel guilty if we want to take care of ours first. That's that training, man. So I'm taking care of my... Look, I feed other people, man, but I got to make sure my kids eat first. You know, I take care... If my child and somebody else's child is drowning, all right, they're in a lake and they drowning. I'm going to tell you something. I don't want that other child to drown, right? But the thing about it is that my focus got to be on saving mine first. Now, once I go out and I grab mine, maybe if I can, if I'm coming back, man, I might grab that other. But the thing about it is this. We got to get to the point, man, and I know that with our people, because of the way in which we feel that we got to have this so-called compassion for all humanity. Well, I got compassion for all humanity. But I'm taking care of mine first. I'd rather for you to be crying than me to be crying. I'd rather for you to lose than me to lose. And until black people, man, start getting on that page, we're going to steady be getting a foot up our ass, bro. You know, I mean, Marcus Garvey said, he said something that's real cold, bro. That's real cold. He said that a people or race, he said exact words were, a race without authority and power deserves no respect. You hear what I just said, Brother Rob?
Say it again.
He said a race without authority and power deserves no respect.